want to thank everybody for watching Crypto Revolution, where I talk about everything crypto daily. Before we jump into this video, I want to say thank you for everybody who's been hitting that like button. Take 2 seconds, smash that like, then leave me a comment and say, hey, Chris, this is the number like I was in the comment section. Helps me grow the channel. If you haven't subscribed to the channel, definitely do so. I'm going to keep you guys up to date on everything crypto related on a daily basis. Jumping right into the market today, crypto sideways. Overall market cap of cryptocurrency, $277 billion. Bitcoin at 97.61. This is a Bitcoin 4 hour chart. So again, we've got our cup and handle, falling wedge. So here's our target, $12,000 Bitcoin, the falling wedge. The cup target, 11,300. Now, one thing that's in the cards too is potentially you've got a rising wedge here. These rising wedges break to the downside about 68% of the time. However, it's hard to bet against Bitcoin right now. There's one time when these rising wedges do break out to the upside, and it's here on the right side of these cups. Potentially, if we do break lower, you could get a shoulder here, right? You could, so you've got inverse head and shoulder, shoulder, head, shoulder. Okay, that's a bullish pattern still. So there's really confident in some future upside for Bitcoin. This weekly close coming up, we need to close here above 95.50 on the weekly candle. So that means Sunday, 7 p.m. Eastern time, we need to be above 95.50 for Bitcoin. That would make this a higher high. So here's your last high, previous high. This high would be higher than this one. So on your weekly chart, this would definitely be a bullish sign. This is showing a trend change. This is a momentum shift, and it's off to the races. Again, over here, Moon Lambo. Now, are we gonna take the shoulder turn, or are we gonna just break out and go to the upside, right? And so you just, again, all eyes are on Bitcoin right here. And we're gonna find out potentially in the next week as far as which way we're headed. Now, zoomed in, this is a 4 hour chart. So you got this smaller white rising wedge, 68% chance of a break to the downside. It looks like it's kind of topping out the price action here. Be perfectly normal and feasible to think that, hey, we're going to run down to around 9,500, okay, which is the lower trend line of this rising wedge. Also, you got a bearish MACD cross that'll be confirmed here probably pretty soon if the price does continue lower. So that's potentially a bearish sign for a short-term move lower, slightly lower. And then just remember, these altcoins are going to continue to do real well if Bitcoin just really moves slow through the weekend. It could be an epic weekend for altcoins. I've got a cryptocurrency trading group. I've got 6 chat groups where everybody's calling out breakouts, posts, and charts, working together. I've got 41 videos in a playlist. If you don't know anything about trading this market, you can watch these videos. You'll be making profitable trades. Number one reason why people join the group is I post these profitable trading setups every single day, and we've been killing it. If you guys want to join the cryptocurrency trading group, you want to pay in crypto, email me, cryptobitcoinchris@gmail.com. I'll get you set up and in the group today. If you pay in crypto for 6 months, you get a 20% discount. If you pay in crypto for the year, you get a 30% discount and an additional month for free. If you do want to pay with a card month to month on a monthly basis, you can do so. There's a Patreon link in the description. Now, this is STX. So I posted this setup on the 4th, 3 days ago. It broke out and killed it. 78% gains for STX in 3 days. This is my Ethereum USDT midterm hold chart, up 33%. These midterm holds are easy. If you're busy, I'll make sure you're in the right coins. Ethereum, 33% gains, huge. Shout out to Crypto Homie. He said, I set a goal to double my half of Bitcoin in 3 months, exactly 1 month ago when I joined. So he's brand new to the group. I just surpassed my goal 2 months early, ahead of schedule. Here he is, total value, 1 Bitcoin. Doubled his money in a month. This gentleman said, hey, Chris, just a quick little update. I've been in the group for about 2.5 months now. Here's a photo of all my altcoin trades I posted from your posted charts. I'm up $3,500 on altcoins. If you're not making a ton of money in this market right now, something's got to change. This is a Bitcoin dominance chart, 4 hour. Okay, so you got Bitcoin dominance getting wrecked. which, what does that mean? Altcoin dominance is obviously skyrocketing. Now, these altcoin seasons are altcoin up cycles, right? We're not talking about the once ever altcoin season that happened 2017. We're saying, hey, altcoins are cycling higher right now. What you want to see is these altcoin up cycles, Bitcoin dominance dropping. You want to see green USDT trading pairs for all your altcoins. And you want to see all the alt BTC trading pairs green as well. So when this happens, you get an altcoin up cycle. And yeah, I mean, it's been amazing. You've seen these, this market has been just taking off. Bitcoin has erased over 45% of its 2019 sell-off in just 7 weeks. And that's one thing you have to remember. This market fluctuates so much that all of a sudden you're down a bunch, down a bunch, down a bunch, and then boom. We got the halving coming up. I think it's like 98 days away from now. Game is about to change, period. Bitcoin touches 10K as altcoin surge double digits. Are we in, is this 2017 all over again? Not quite yet. What I'm considering is it's potentially looking like the beginning of 2018 where Bitcoin started to move higher, you know, ran up to 14,000. These altcoins took off with Bitcoin, and these altcoins, it was amazing gains. And then Bitcoin broke out and shot up to 14,000. You know, so everybody kind of pivoted to Bitcoin. And there's a point in this market where you'll need to do so. You know, shift from altcoins to Bitcoin and shift from Bitcoin to altcoins, right? Because, I mean, essentially, you've got your money in this market. You want it to be in the coins that are going to make you the most profits. And these bull runs, these bull markets, it's not about how do I make money in this market. It's how do I make the most money in this market. If you're sitting in coins right now where you're not making gains and they're stale coins, you're missing out on a lot of opportunities, right? Maybe you're not taking losses, so that's good. But if you're just sitting there holding some of these coins and they're not moving, so potentially want to look at a strategy where you pivot. You know, once one coin runs up crazy, pull it out, move it to another coin that hasn't popped yet. You know, so that's important to understand how that works. Huge news from the SEC. So the SEC is talking about a safe harbor type situation with crypto. This would be groundbreaking for the United States market. So the U.S. SEC Commissioner Hester Peirce is presenting a new proposal on how to regulate cryptocurrencies. Under her plan, U.S. regulators would dramatically shift how they're attempting to regulate blockchain-based digital assets. They no longer would classify them as financial securities. Only a handful of cryptos right now, basically Bitcoin and Ethereum, have been exempt from U.S. securities laws. They really just haven't come out and pointed a bunch of fingers at any other coins. This safe harbor proposal basically would allow these companies that issue digital tokens to get some breathing room so they can establish their networks and communities before dealing with the regulatory requirements. So CZ from Binance, CEO of Binance, says this development would give projects runway to build robust networks. The proposed safe harbor puts an important stake in the ground towards supporting American access and acceptance of digital asset markets. This would be the break that we need in the United States. This would be huge. You know, the SEC, they're trying to protect us. I mean, let's face it, a lot of people got wrecked in cryptocurrency. A lot of retail FOMO's in, they don't know what they're doing, and they lose a ton of money. And so I see both sides. SEC is trying to basically lay some type of groundwork in place now, and so things are looking a lot brighter. The future is golden. Ethereum is about to rocket past $300 as bullish confluence grows. Ethereum's been killing it. Here's my Ethereum midterm hold setup. Again, I posted it down here when Ethereum was about $144 down here. Okay, and so, you know, I'm thinking, hey, this $275 target might take 2 months to reach this level, which is up here. Man, here we are, 223. Now, we have to think about a pullback. And so what I'm looking at, you just almost have to wonder, like, you got this huge parabolic. When these coins go parabolic, that's the fastest, quickest, most intense gains you're going to get in this market. So you're looking for these rounded parabolic price moves. Get a pullback would be healthy, all right? Some type of pullback. And what you're looking for is a bounce to buy if you want to get back in this guy. Ride it up to 275. After that, it's going to go to 314. And again, this could take a number of weeks or months to play out. How big is this pullback going to be if it happens? Industry's most powerful man, only one in a thousand own crypto. Who is the industry's most powerful man? I want to ask you guys this. Leave a comment in the comment box. Here's who they say the industry's most powerful man is. CZ. I mean, think about it. He is a CEO of one of the largest exchanges in the world. The largest exchange by volume, right? So he said one in a thousand people own cryptocurrency right now. But this could reach 50% of the population within 30 years. I read this and I said, you know, this is probably not going to make a bunch of people excited, because 30 years, half of the world uses crypto seems like not fast enough, right? For what I think YouTube and crypto paints a picture like this is all going to happen tomorrow, right? And you just have to remember that adoption plays part in the price, right? But think about everybody that's been in cryptocurrency for the last 10 years, let's say Bitcoin. They're rich. If you got in Bitcoin 7, 8, 9, 10 years ago, you're ridiculously rich. And that didn't have a whole lot to do with adoption or use case. It has to do with speculation, right? And so understand that, hey, there's some time that's gonna have to pass for this to be adopted. You know, I've got a gentleman in my trading group, and we were talking about credit cards, and it took credit cards a number of years, and in the United States, potentially people are gonna say, hey, we've got this system that works already. Why do we need crypto? We've got banks and we've got credit cards, and what do we need anything better? You know, that a lot of people have that idea in their head is like, well, why should I change if I have something that works? So I think crypto is gonna take off in developing countries before potentially the United States. Allsbit crypto exchange that got hacked. Almost all the funds are gone. Well, you know what? Their hot wallet was completely emptied by suspected cyber criminals. Well, you know what? It's a hot wallet. It's online. These exchanges, listen, they know better. Like, you can't keep a bunch of your money online exposed. Like, all your larger exchanges, let's say Bittrex, they've got insurance now on their cold storage. And these exchanges, they pull all the crypto off, and they only keep a minimal amount in their hot wallet. So I wonder, what has Allsbit really got going on? If you guys haven't picked up a Ledger Nano X, right now there's a Valentine's pack. Same thing as a Christmas deal. You get a Ledger Nano X and a Ledger Nano S for free for the price of $119. So amazing savings. If you want to store your cryptocurrency offline cold storage, you have some coins that you hodl, this is the way to do it. There's a factory link that's in the description that does support the channel. Tron CEO gives Warren Buffett a Samsung Galaxy Fold with wallet containing Bitcoin and TRX. And what I thought was interesting is that he gave Warren Buffett, this gentleman here, who is a billionaire for a reason, many, 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 many times over, and he gave him a Galaxy Fold, this phone. And I just wonder, you know, Warren Buffett, he lives in his original house that he's lived in forever. You know, I think he bought it for about $40,000 years and years ago, quite a few decades ago. It's now worth $600,000 because it's increased in price, but he's kind of old fashioned, okay? And I'm just wondering if he's going to unfold this Galaxy Fold, which, by the way, looks like a pretty cool phone. But remember, down here, he's super proud of it. It says supported cryptocurrencies, Ethereum, Bitcoin, Clayton, and Tron. And fair enough, he's got that deal. Tron's got that deal, that TRX deal with Samsung. So they're supported crypto. Chainlink soars 11% with promise of fair flight insurance. So this is a decentralized insurance platform called EtherRisk. It's now using Chainlink's decentralized oracles for its data feeds, ensuring a fair and more efficient way for claimants to get paid. So again, Chainlink staying in the news. This is important to look for in your cryptocurrency. Shout out to EJ Property Management. They've been in my trading group, and they got these XRP plates in Maryland, and they're super excited about this. So shout out to XRP holders. NEO price analysis, bullish trend emerges despite little on-chain activity. I don't think on-chain activity right now has a whole lot to do with price action. I think there's a lot of speculation. I mean, think about it. What changed over the past 45, 50, 60 days in cryptocurrency that has this entire market taking off, Ripple partner MoneyGram secures a $9 million investment from Brinks. So remember, Brinks, you always see their Brinks trucks that drive around, those armored trucks, and they're transporting cash. Well, they're smart enough to say, hey, you know what, we might need to get involved with MoneyGram, who is, you know, Ripple is heavily invested in MoneyGram. And they say, hey, as we move to a cashless society, it only makes sense for Brinks to get involved in digital currencies, potentially MoneyGram, Brinks, and Ripple working together. Ripple co-founder has now sold 1 billion XRP. Is it affecting the price of the third largest crypto? Let's look at the chart. I've got a midterm hold on this. Let me show you. So, is it affecting? Not really. Not really. I mean, yeah, you've got this huge downtrend. This is a falling wedge, 68% chance of a break higher, and it did. Now what I'm looking for is a break above this level. If there's a pullback, that's going to be a better entry. If you get a pullback to 24 cents and then it takes off, that'd be great, right? You want to get the best deal. But if it starts to break higher than this, there's a lot of upside. 44 cents is in the cards. Before that, it's going to run into 38 cents. It's going to run into 38 cents and kind of get stuck. Why? It's going to take some time to play out. It's not going to happen overnight. It might take a month. It might take 2 months. Watch XRP. The chart looks good. If you guys like the content that I provide on a daily basis, please subscribe to the channel, like the video, comment below, hit the bell for notifications. Thanks so much. I'll see you guys tomorrow.